you will hear a bunch of ahadith pertaining to the verses of the middle of Sha'ban. For instance, take this hadith, which is very straightforward in the mandate of fasting on the 15th day and praying all night or as much as you can of the 15th night. The hadith says, إِذَا كَانَ لَيْلَةُ النُّصْفِ مِنْ شَعْبَانَ فَقُومُوا لَيْلَهَا وَصُومُوا نَهَارَهَا. Fake. Fabricated. All the ahadith which are narrated in this regard have no essence. And even the weak ahadith, which some of the scholars judge them as weak, we do not rely on them in initiating an act of worship. Is the middle of Sha'ban a blessed night? It is a blessed night. But is there any special celebration or special act of worship to be done on that night? Not a single reference in this regard. Yes, in a hadith which judge as Hassan, that the Prophet ﷺ said, whenever it is the middle of Sha'ban, Allah looks at the believers and he pardons them, and looks at the disbelievers and he gives them a postponal or and so on. But there is no direct evidence or hadith that commands us or recommends for us to do any worship or celebration on the 15th of Sha'ban, whether the day and or the night. And I hope this is clear. It becomes very hard to eliminate the cultural traditions from our daily activities and acts of worship as if it is a deen. It is not a deen. And this is not the opinion of Sheikh Muhammad Salah, this opinion of the great scholars and Ahlul Sunnah from the very past and until today in the fatwa committees. Similar to what we stated before with regards to Nuh ibn Abi Maryam narrating and fabricating hundreds of ahadith pertaining to the verses of the different chapters of the Quran. Some people are addicted to that, are so attached to these ahadith and say, Surah such and such has a great virtue. And if you recite it one time before going to sleep, you will never turn poor. And if you recite this surah on the day of whatever, you will never get this. And. This guy himself, Nuh ibn Abi Maryam, confessed that he made up these ahadith. He made them up. He fabricated them. He said, I noticed that the people kept busy studying the hadith and the sunnah and the seerah and the history of Ibn Asakir and others and the fiqh of Abi Hanifa. So I thought, it would be great. It would be a great idea if I can bring the people back into the Quran. So he made up. He invented and fabricated those ahadith with regards to the verses of certain surahs in order to attract people to read them. Do we still rely on them? No. The deen in the Islamic heritage is very unique. You cannot find that in any other religion. You can verify and trace any ahadith or a statement to find out whether it is profound or not, said by the Prophet ﷺ or not, sound or weak or fabricated. So whenever it is sound, we rely on it. But if it is not sound, neglect it and move on.